ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्मविद्यासम्प्रदायकर्तृभ्यो वंशऋषद्भ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहितप्रज्ञानघनप्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोऽहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ॐ प्रपन्नपारिजाताय तोत्रवेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। ओम नमो वेंकटेशाय। माय बेस्ट विशेस एंड परिपूर्ण आशीर्वादम्स टू ऑल द व्यूअर्स ऑफ श्री वेंकटेश्वर भक्ति चैनल। मे द ऑलमाइटी श्री लॉर्ड वेंकटेश्वर बिस्टू ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी हेल्थ वेल्थ एंड इटर्नल हैप्पीनेस विद परिपूर्ण लक्ष्मी कटाक्षम्स टू यू एंड योर एंटायर फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड फ्रेंड्स। लेट अस बिगिन Bhagavad-gita, verse number 46 of 6th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Tapasvibhyo Dhiko Yogi Jnanibhyo Pimato Dhikah Karmibhyascha Dhiko Yogi Tasmad Yogi Bhavarjuna. After giving the answers to the question from Arjuna, Bhagavan Krishna continues again the teaching. Now this verse is very important verse. So in which he emphasizes the Vedantic meditator alone supreme. There are other people also called the categories of other yogis have been introduced. Totally there are four yogis including Vedantic yogi. Vedantic meditator is known as Vedantic yogi. And tapasvi, who is endowed with life with complete discipline. Then karma yogi. Then jnani with Vedantic yogi. So among these four yogis, Vedantic meditator is the supreme one. He is the greatest yogi among these four. Now we have to descend the method which he is presented through these words. So now we have to analyze. So by giving the comparatively the expression about the glorifying yogi is for what? Because all of them are on the way to reach the destination. Once they reach the destination, they will get moksha. All these yogis are on the path, but this Vedantic yogi is very close to moksha. Now we can bring the order. First, karmi. Karmi means karma yogi. Karmi means we are not talking about somebody who earns money by doing something. No, karma yogi means a person who could bring yajna bhava from third chapter. You have to remember yajnyarthat karmanon yatra lokoyam karma bandhanah tadartham kuru kaunteya. You have to bring the attitude from there. The person who is able to bring the attitude called yajna bhavana, that yajna bhavana which converts every action into yoga, that person is the first standard kept in the preliminary stage. This Vedantic jnani is greater than them. So those people who are committed to bring yajna bhavana is the preliminary stage people. The sadhaka, to be a Vedanti, he has to begin with karma yoga. No doubt. Because the karma yoga gives the eligibility. If they are yoga bhrashtaha, then the matter is different. Because already they had done karma yoga in the past births. And one more thing also, you should be very clear. Some of you may have the doubt. So when a person is following the spiritual path, for example, he is following the karma yoga and he has entered into jnana yoga, Now he is pursuing the knowledge. In between, he is dropped his tapas. In between, he stopped his studies because of he had to go undergo the death. Again, he is born. What about Sanchita Karma? Do you know what Sanchita Karma means? Sanchita means the whole accumulative karma phalas from past all births. Because we had undergone innumerable, means crores of birth and death, birth and death. So all accounts are kept as a whole amount of karma phala. Now we are born to enjoy certain amount of karma phala with a limited amount of karma phala, but still the stock is there. Then agami, it is known as prarabdha, means I have taken small amount of karma phala to enjoy. Long back I told you, these three karma phalas must be realized. Prarabdham, Sanchitam, Agami. I think you will remember this. Still I explain for newcomers. See, if you earn money for a month, 10,000 rupees. That is very minimum nowadays, but let it be 10,000 rupees. So whole the earning of 1 month is there in your hand as 10,000 rupees. You deposit in the bank. Deposit means not as a fixed deposit. So you deposit as a savings account. Now 10,000 is there in your bank account, in your account. So you withdraw 1,000 rupees for this day. The date is the first day. So now you withdraw 1,000 rupees. Now you have to spend whole day and you have to nourish yourself. You have to get all the business also through this, all kinds of transaction, taking care of your family. So everything to be done with this 1,000 rupees. You do that. But end of the day, you gain more profit because karma theory, there is no nashtam, there is no loss. You gain either punya or papa. So at the end of the day, you get, means 300 rupees profit. Now you have 1,300 rupees in your hand. You deposit again in the bank. Now there is going to be 10,300 rupees, isn't it? This is the example. The 10,000 whole amount which was earning of the last month known as Sanchita Karma. We accumulate lots of karmas from so many births is known as Sanchita Karma. And the 1,000 rupees which was taken to take care of the day, the particular day is known as Prarabdha Karma. Now we have taken the body for 100 years or 60 years, 50 years, 70, 80, whatever the years we are going to live. So the Prarabdha Karma will allow us to continue with our age. That Prarabdha Karma means the limited amount which is withdrawn to enjoy. While enjoying itself, we earn more because of Ahankara. There where Shastra comes. So while enjoying the Prarabdha Karma, if you are endowed with a normal mentality, you can earn more Punya and Papa, you can increase your birth and death. But the spiritual seeker, he does the job with Ahankara because Ahankara becomes the enjoyer. You have to enjoy your karma phala. We have to no option. But while enjoying, if you are bringing proper attitude, from that point you are saved. Neha bhikramana shosti pratyavayona vidyate svalpam apyasya dharmasya trayate mahato bhayat. That's what taught in the second chapter itself. When you begin karma yoga, don't worry, there is no hurdles, no dosha, pratyavaya dosha means no side effect, just you can go. Even if you do alpa prayatanam, a small amount of effort to bring proper attitude in your every karma, that will bring the great benefit. There where we get the different path, spiritual progress. So this the whole transaction is done. That is known as prarabdha. While enjoying prarabdha karma, you earn more. That 300 rupees is agami karma. Now whole amount 10,000 is equal to sanchita karma, the 1,000 rupees which symbolizes prarabdha karma, the 300 rupees which was earned, it's agami karma. So every second you are earning agami karma. So in every second you are spending prarabdha karma. The spending prarabdha karma, by that with the ignorance you become capable of earning new agami karma. Agami means the future, that which comes. By learning or becoming a sadhaka of jnana yogi, so you are detached with prarabdha karma for the time being. In the same way, so when he passes away during the sadhana, the sanchita karma has been given a stay order. It won't affect. If sanchita karma works, you will be born according to the sanchita karma, not according to the sadhana. Now you become yoga bhrashtaha. It means what? It's been stay ordered. Now you will have the birth according to your sadhana in different places. From there you will continue the study, then you achieve knowledge, then the sanchita karma will be vanished completely. So glorified method that we have to realize it. This karma yogi is the preliminary yogi, and beyond that upasana yogi. So one more person is called upasana yogi. So he is not endowed with even karmas. So he only does mentally meditation. Upasana means manasika saguna brahma manasika vyaparaha. He become more eligible than this karma yogi. He doesn't have the urge to work. He can sit and he can contemplate on any deity. It is greater than that karma yogi. Depending on the world, now he is not depending on the world. He himself is doing upasana. Upasana means a kind of meditation, worship, that which is done mentally. So this Ramakrishna was Kali Upasaka. So upasaka means you select the deity, you become one with the deity, keep on doing that. Upasana gives more fruit. That upasana, even with selflessness, it brings the eligibility to become Shravana Karta. So now you can cross that, the two level. The first preliminary was Karma Yogi. Then second one is known as Upasana Yogi. So now, once you are matured enough, you can become so Vedantic student, known as a Shravana Manana Yogi. Now he considers whoever listening to yoga, Vedanta, he is also yogi. That's what Jnani is. So Jnani is the word. It is glorifying the student of Vedanta itself. He just listened to the Vedanta. So listening Vedanta itself makes you or gives you a state or status of a yogi. So great, that's what Krishna is. Krishna never disgraces you. He always encourages. That's what, you know, this, the Shravana means who is listening to Vedanta, studying Vedanta, he becomes a yogi. Studying and understanding, but without Nididhyasanam, only Shravanam and Mananam is going on. Then Nididhyasanam means it is greater than him. Now, from the first karma yogi to one should become what? Upasana yogi. From upasana yogi to one should become what? Shravana yogi. Shravana manana yogi. From shravana manana yogi to one can become Vedantic yogi, meditator. This Vedantic meditator alone worshipped or glorified by Lord Krishna. Therefore, yogi Bhavarjuna, therefore you become the Vedantic meditator, not the normal meditator. Because this meditator alone does the final job, is a final tune. He is very closest to the moksha. He will gain moksha. And don't worry, when will it get? If you started doing meditation, that's what, you know, many people come to us and ask, Swamiji, I've been doing meditation, but I'm not able to become calm. I'm expecting peaceful mind, but I'm not able to set the peaceful mind. Then our suggestion, so don't meditate for the peace. Meditate with the peace. That's what I'm not able to. That's what I'm not able to. Then I said, don't engage yourself with the expectation of the peace. Just drop the expectations. Just sit for the meditation. You will get it. In the same way, when I will get moksha, when I will get moksha, when I will get moksha, while doing karma yoga itself, when I will get moksha, don't think about it. Moksha will take place. If you follow what to be followed, moksha will take place its own. We need not worry about it. The worryless yogi is a meditator. And this meditator, even he is not depending on world. He is not depending on Ishvara. He is not depending on any other source than his own Atma. So now that yogi who could identify himself, who could be absorbed by Atma alone, that yogi is greater than all other yogi. He continues, Yogi namapi sarvesham madgatenantaratmanam shraddhavan bhajate yomam sameyuktatam omataha. Among all the yogi nam, among all the other yogis, which was said in the last words, and whatever the, there are so many other yogis, there are meditating yogis, according to Patanjali, let them be. Sarvesham madgatena antaratmana shraddhavan yogi yuktatamaha iti me mataha. A person who is endowed with lots of shraddha, studied Vedanta, and in order to gain the nishtha, in order to gain the assimilation, one who could sit in the meditation with his mind, who could meditate on me as his own I. That is very important. Who is meditating on me becomes yogi, that's not said by Krishna. So he adds, you know, who could meditate me as his own self, he becomes the proper yukta tamaha, means greatest yogi. He becomes the greatest meditator in the world. So whoever the meditators are introduced in our scriptures, so among all those yogis, he becomes the greatest one. Yukta tamaha iti me mataha. Now he has concluded. So final conclusion, he is the meditator. He is the meditator who could reach the moksha. The solid message is given by Lord Krishna. He concludes, Iti Srimad Bhagavad Gitasu Upanishatsu Brahma Vidyayam Yoga Shastre Shri Krishna Arjuna Samvade Atma Samyama Yogo Nama Dhyana Yogo Nama Shashthodhyayah. So proper conclusion by our rishis. So Bhagavad Gita, when was narrated, these conclusions were not there. I think Veda Vyasa might have done these things. The proper concluding sentences which we have read, Iti Srimad Bhagavad Gita Su. Thus, in the Bhagavad Gita, which is nothing but Upanishads, Upanishatsu. Upanishatsu means what? That which takes you to closer to the Guru. Taking closer to the Guru, it takes you closer to Ishvara, from Ishvara to you. You can get closer you to yourself through getting closer to Guru, closer to Ishvara. That proximity. Here the proximity is spoken about. So you have the proper proximity with yourself, but that proximity is not felt, not experienced. Therefore, the proximity of a Guru, proximity of Shastra, proximity of Ishvara, all together will give the proximity, means closeness with yourself. Therefore, it is known as Upanishad, Upanishatsu, that which is equal to the Upanishad. In the Bhagavad Gita, which is equal to Upanishad, Brahma Vidyayam, in the context which talks about Brahma Vidya, Yoga Shastre, that which is nothing but Yoga Shastra, so which can define a proper meditator. Vedantic meditator is the supreme meditator. Yoga Shastre, Shri Krishna Arjuna Samvade, that which is in the dialogue form between Krishna and Arjuna. Atma Samyama Yogo Nama. So certain book it is right in that way. Atma Samyama means, Atma means here is mind. The Samyama means the process, meditation. So Dhyana method, Atma Samyama Yoga Nama. So that is explained here, the yoga, the chapter which helps to get Atma Samyama, to the proper regulation of the mind, otherwise known as Dhyana Yoga. So sixth chapter is being concluded. The great thing by Lord Krishna. So we will begin the seventh chapter. Let me chant. Atha Saptamo Dhyayah. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, Maya Saktamana Partha, Yogam Yunjan Madashrayaha, Asam Shayam Samagramam, Yathagnya Sitachrunu. We have just started seventh chapter, but before that, we need to have the chapter's summary, and we need to have all compiling six chapters summary, because this first six chapters are very important chapter in the scriptures, because other Vedantic text they approach in different way, but Bhagavad Gita approaches in different way, because Bhagavad Gita was taught to a friend. So who could convert himself to in the form of student? In the Bhagavad Gita, there are so many discussions about karmas. So Bhagavad Gita, which contains the first, especially the first satka, so which is organized all the things which related to an individual personality. Finally, he concluded. Now we will begin the next episode with the proper summary of the sixth chapter, and that summary will also include the summary of all the six chapters. Would you understand? So when I am going to give the summary of sixth chapter, it will contain all summary of six chapters. Could you understand what I say? So with the help of Guru's grace, with the help of all the Acharya's grace, definitely we will get that opportunity, because the lots of Punya we have that sure, because you are hearing this for the past few months continuously, it means you have definitely fortunate enough. So that you are fortunate enough to be a listener of Bhagavad Gita, definitely we will continue that assimilation part also. You should practice meditation every day with the content. Okay? You take a shloka, go on again and again. The sixth chapter itself has got all the essence of all five chapters. If you have doubt, you can get the recollection, means like a Simhavalokana, and bring back and started doing meditation. Meditation means I am suggesting Vedantic meditation, that we will definitely will get the target, and I will continue from the next episode. Harihi Om, Shri Gurubhyo Namo Namah. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om, Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Now